Right, welcome back. I'm Lostwolfe, and I'm your host. We're doing a King's Quest 1 playthrough. So, last time when I left you, we were going to go and inspect the rock. Let's talk about the rock very quickly. The idea here is that this whole lot is up on a hill, so when you do anything to the rock is going to go down this way. This is one of those things that Zero were trying to do to emphasize how 3D the game was, so we're going to push the rock. With a heave and a hoe, you manage to move the rock, revealing a dark hole underneath it. And there's the dark hole. Look in the hole. There is an intricately carved dagger in the hole. We're going to get the dagger. You reach into the hole and grasp the dagger, being careful not to cut yourself. There's one thing I do want to emphasize about this very quickly. This is not an infocom parser, so you can't say get rock and dagger. I don't understand and. So you can't do compound sentences, they have to be fairly simple sentences. Last episode I forgot to show you the egg, so let's look at that. The smooth golden egg shines brightly in the sunlight. And the dagger itself. Its handle is beautifully carved by, the blade is bronze and very sharp. Right, okay. We have our friend, the dagger. Dagger's gonna come in and useful soon. We're just gonna travel along the landscape. One thing I do wanna show you very quickly is the swim command, because I haven't yet. So there's you drowning, there's you swimming. Oh, there's going to be some technical weirdness where I keep on forgetting to call him Prince or Sir Graham. That's who he is, he's Sir Graham. Also, you will have noticed, I put the sound back on. Because we no longer have a very terrible sound. Well, there's going to be bits of music, but not a lot of bits of music. Okay, that's not what we want. We will go there, but not quite yet. Downs, grab you by the neck and carries you off to a fate worse than death. She's a wicked witch, so she's gonna eat you. It's not really productive. Okay. I think this will be a little safer. Yeah, we don't have to worry about the wolf now. Hey, the wolf! Was fixing to have dinner. Everything in this game wants to kill you or eat you or something. Terrible. Hi, Mr. Wolf. Run, little guy. Okay. We do want that, but not quite yet. Oh, goodness. this is going to be terrible. This really is. I should be high in the sky. You see a very large, friendly bird. We don't have the things to help to deal with the bird quite yet, so we're not going to go there. I don't actually remember if there's anything in the stump. Oh, I won't worry about that. Ah, this is exactly where I wanted to go. As with most games of this age, this is really just a treasure hunt. So what you have to do is you have to wander around and you have to find the bits that solve all the puzzles. Now, the couple of bits that I'm looking for kind of not where I thought they'd be. No. That certainly isn't where I thought it'd be. Oh, goodness. Don't want to fall in there. today's playthrough is clearly not going to be productive. I'm gonna walk around. Yay! Oh, there we go. That's what I was looking for. Right. Oh, hang on. We need to look at the room. There appears to be some sort of ball on the ground. Get ball. You pick up the ceramic ball. Look, ball. That's the other thing you can do. You can look inside the ball. You notice a word on the bottom of the ball. Read. Word. The word at the bottom of the ball says ball. This is exactly where I wanted to be. And here we have a big tree. Let's look at the room. There is a large walnut tree surrounded by several pine trees. Look, walnut. These are some of the finest walnuts you have ever seen. Get walnut. You pluck a nice walnut from the tree. Let's have a look at the walnut. It seems to be a good solid walnut. Turns out that you can open walnuts. When you open the walnut, you discover the nut inside is pure gold. And we're gonna save. There's one guy you can sort of deal with because he steals your stuff but you can get it back. But it's still kind of a pain in the butt. Yeah, the sound is pretty loud, isn't it? Right, this is the other bit I'm after. This bit is sort of pain and torture because you never quite know if the Wicked Witch is going to be here or not. And if she's not here, you've only got a very limited time to get in there and get all the stuff you need. So we're going to eat house. Good, she's not here. Okay, house. Open door. You open the door. Look. Yeah, I need to be a little closer. Right. The cupboard on the wall is rather plain and simple. Open cupboard. Look, cupboard. Sitting on the shelf is a delicious piece of Swiss cheese. Get cheese. You pluck the Swiss cheese from the shelf. Now, here's the part where it might go wrong. See if I'm gonna, off in the distance you hear a high squeaking voice say, I can smell someone tasty in my house. So we're gonna see if we can get, you grab the note from the table. Okay, we're gonna read it outside because if I read it now we're just gonna be wasting time. Let's see if we can get out before she shows up. Yeah, that's good. Okay. So let's have a look at the note that we scored. Actually, let's have a look at the cheese too, as long as we're here. Cheese. The Swiss cheese looks fresh and moist. The note. There is a message written on the note. Read message. The note reads, sometimes it is wise to think backwards. Now, there's more than one version of this game. Like, there's at least four or five. And in some of the old versions of the game, the solution to the puzzle that it's hinting at was very, very obscure. And that is about all that we're going to be able to do for today. I'm Lostwolfe and I'm signing off and I shall see you soon. Right.